On Stay Tuned, a traditional feminist voices how she feels about Beyoncé and her latest album. LU remembers the time celebrating another year in a new way. And the university continues to celebrate into the month of April, kicking off a celebration worth $50,000.
Hello and welcome to Stay Tuned. I'm Daryl Strong.
And I'm Danika Hill. Starting off this week's show is our international news. North and South Korea exchanged fire on bordering waters. North Korea's shells landed in South Korea during military drills. South Korea responded with heavy fire. Explosions forced residents of five South Korean islands to evacuate their homes. Luckily, there were no injuries.
Gun control is becoming more of a problem here in the United States. A shooting in Fort Hood, Texas leaves four dead and 16 injured. The shooter was a former soldier being treated for mental illness. The attackers opened fire, killing three people and wounding several others before taking his own life. Fort Hood is also the infamous site for the 2009 shooting at the hands of an Army psychiatrist who was an alleged Muslim extremist. Authorities say that the shooter was transferred to Fort Hood from another military base in February. He was said to be suffering from a traumatic brain injury that was not combat related. However, the suspect was undergoing a diagnosis process to determine whether he suffered from post-traumatic stress disorder. However, no diagnosis was made.
Langston University's GOAT Research Department is number one in the country. The Langston University GOAT Research Department has made national news. The Communication Department's broadcast writing class has the story.
The Ikika de la Garza program at Langston University is one of the nation's leading GOAT research programs. The program recently made national headlines for its use of goats in preventing Oklahoma brush fires. The goats have specific tasks and uses.
Breeds that we have that are called meat breeds are based on the African boar goat. It's called a boar goat, and we have a large herd of those. Those have traits for high production of good quality meat. We also have Spanish goats, and we have crosses between these animals that we use for meat production.
The goats are expected to produce the best quality. The dairy breeds produce the most milk, and the meat breeds produce the most muscle, which ensure a leaner meat. This serves as an alternative to the meat cows provide, which tends to be a fattier meat. There is also a difference in breeding for the dairy and meat breeds.
Breeding normally for dairy goats, they are seasonal. In other words, they will breed mainly in October, November, then start milking in March, April. But for meat goats, they can pretty much breed year-round more readily.
The most important duties in caring for the goats include keeping them parasite-free, improving reproductive efficiency, and controlling brush fires.
Now to Keisha in the field with one problem and two solutions.
I'm Keisha Clark here with One Problem, Two Solutions. One Problem, Two Solutions is part of our program where we give our viewers and students a chance to give their opinions with on-standing issues on campus. So I'm here with the freshman Jelani Johnson. Jelani, how are you?
I'm doing good, and yourself?
I'm good. So what one problem do you have on campus?
My problem is that the food variety here, I think they should change it up.
So what two solutions do you have for your problem?
Well, number one, I think we should change the burgers. You know, everybody gets tired of the same thing. We need something different. My other solution would be the salad bar or the pieces. I think that we need to freshen up, bring something new, and I think the kids would be more happy and more willing to come to the cafeteria.
Okay, thank you. That was a great solution. Well, there you have it. If you have any more questions, comments, concerns, or suggestions, you can contact us at lustaytuned@gmail.com. You heard it here first. Make sure you always stay tuned. Back to you in the studio.
Next up, we have Andre Morgan in the field at the closing ceremony of Women's History Month.
Hello everyone, my name is Andrea Morgan, here with LU Stay Tuned. I am currently in front of the atrium where guest speaker Rahiel Tesfamariam is speaking to the women of Langston University, closing out our Women's History Month celebration.
Writer, blogger, activist Rahiel Tesfamariam spoke to the women of Langston University to end the Women's History Month festivities. Tesfamariam encouraged the women to embrace their inner and outer beauty. She emphasized that as Black women, we can be beautiful without being sexual objects, a major issue she had with Beyoncé's latest album.
Think about it. Even when we're depicted as powerful, there's an underlying statement about it.
At the end of her speech, she told the girls to find a mentor and learn from her so that they can one day change society's views on Black women.
I gave a sermon yesterday, and one of the questions I left them with was, who taught you to dim your light? And, you know, so that's a question that I asked tonight, too. Who taught you to dim your light? What taught you to dim your light, right? And after a while, you have to ask yourself, why am I going to continue to allow that thing or that person or that system to have this much power over me? Nothing should have that much power over you that it affects how much you love yourself or don't love yourself. It affects how you look at yourself in the mirror. You've surrendered your power. To get it back, you have to say that I'm going to love myself despite what anyone else says. That I'm going to love myself because I know I'm a child of God. And once you get that you're a child of God, it's really hard not to fall madly in love with yourself.
That is very true. And I want to thank you again on behalf of LU Stay Tuned and Langston University for coming out to speak to us. And make sure you always stay tuned. Back
Thanks,
to you,
Langston.
Happy belated birthday to our dear Langston University. Langston University is officially 117 years old. To celebrate this amazing milestone, the Langston University Ambassadors and LU Stay Tuned brought the Campus Founders Week.
The week consisted of a block party, a scavenger hunt, and Why I Love LU kickoff celebration. But the birthday party was the highlight of the week, bringing in Qdoba's, birthday cake, and even the president. The Founders Day convocation brought the Honorable Judge Vicki Miles LaGrange to LU to speak about the importance of school and the Langston legacy that has made students that changed the world.
Happy birthday, Langston University, again from us here at Stay Tuned.
Now to Jasmine Rideau in the field with the Brain Fart Question of the Week.
Hey guys, I'm Jasmine Rideau here with LU Stay Tuned Brain Fart Question of the Week. This week we're dedicating it to Women's History Month, and I'm here with Kiara Kane, who's a sophomore here at Langston University. And our Brain Fart Question of the Week is, we know Dr. Joanne Haysburg was our last female president, but how many female presidents has Langston University had?
Five.
All right. Well, that's not the correct answer, but we are going to keep the show moving.
I didn't study for this test, but I'm going to go with two.
Close. Very close, but not quite it.
About 15. I'm going to go close to 15.
15. Okay. Can you name one other than Dr. Joanne Haysburg?
Tiffany Smith.
Tiffany Hill Smith. That is our first lady, but at least you know her.
Only one, and she's been the first and only one of our race and of the opposite sex who's been president at this institution since it was founded way back in 1897, just before Oklahoma had entered statehood 10 years later in 1907, because previously it was called Indian Territory, and when it entered statehood 10 years later in 1907, pardon me, it became Oklahoma, and the name is Oklahoma is Indian. It means red people.
Yes, absolutely. That is a legendary Butch Benjamin, the only guy that got our Brain Fart Question of the Week answer correct. Thank you, Mr. Benjamin Butts.
You're welcome.
Butch Benjamin. Thank you, Mr. Butch Benjamin.
Thank you.
Back to you guys in the studio.
Hi, this is Tom Joyner. And alumni, I'm calling on you. Represent for Langston University by spreading the word about the School of the Month campaign. You can support a scholar at your school by going to TomJoynerFoundation.org and click donate today. Your tax-deductible donation can make a difference all year long.
Who needs a lemonade stand when you have Tom Joyner? Each month, the Tom Joyner Foundation chooses an HBCU to be the School of the Month. For the month of April, he has selected Langston University, and he has challenged alumni, students, and any supporters to donate. James Monroe is in the Student Success Center at the kickoff celebration.
What's going on, Langston University? I'm James Monroe from State Team. Here at the Student Success Center, as you can see, we're celebrating Tom Joyner choosing Langston University for the April School of the Month. We've had the drumline perform, we have had the president, we have the big six organizations and everything you can think of. Make sure that you always stay tuned because we will have a story to come.
The Office of Student Life presented a kickoff celebration with entertainment, food, and special presentations to get Langston University ready to support Tom Joyner and his movement to raise money for Langston University. The kickoff brought out members of the Big Six organizations to donate at least $500 to go toward the $50,000 donations minimum. James Donovan, Assistant Vice President for Institutional Advancement and Development, spoke with Stay Tuned about how the selection came about.
Well, the Tom Joyner Foundation reaches out to an HBCU every month. This is the third time we've been selected over the last, I guess, about 15 years. The last time we were the School of the Month was in 2009. And our goal this year is to raise $50,000. All of the money goes to scholarships for Langston students.
To donate today, either visit TomJoynerFoundation.org and hit Donate Today, or simply visit our website at langston.edu and follow the link available.
Thank you for tuning in to Stay Tuned's 10th episode.
Make sure you follow us on Instagram and Twitter at LU Stay Tuned, and make sure that you subscribe to our YouTube channel at LU Stay Tuned.
I'm Daryl Strong.
And I'm Danika Hill.
Make sure that you always
stay tuned.